24 drivers. There are 8 of those drivers eligible for a $1,000 bonus paid by City Chevrolet. City Chevrolet, Chris Knight and the gang putting up a $1,000 bonus. So they're filtering out of the racetrack right now, getting ready to go. Chris Ferguson from Mount Holly is going to be on the pole aboard that number 22 Carver and Sons machine. Fergie up front. The top four redrew. There was a redraw amongst the top four. So Chris Ferguson inside of row number one of the 22 car on the outside aboard the Circle K. Polar Pop number 25. Charlotte, North Carolina's Matt Long. So it's Fergie and Matt Long in row one. In row two, on the inside of row number two, from Appling, Georgia, in that white and red number 76 Budweiser Wolfpack Racing machine, it's Brandon Overton. Brandon Overton in the 76, outside of Overton in row two. Originally a championship modified racer from the Midwest, he's worked for race teams in the Charlotte area for the last decade, the 18 of Brent Glassdetter. Brent Glassdetter in row two. Row three, on the inside, the number 11 Highbridge Automotive machine, Inman, South Carolina's David Smith. So Hollywood Smith goes inside of row three aboard the 11 car to his outside. From Lancaster, South Carolina, in the blue T1, it's Timbo Mangum. Timbo, don't mess around with me, Mangum, on the outside of David Smith. Back in row four, it's the 00 of Greg Clark. He's on the inside of the 22 of Johnny Austin. Riverside, California's David Gilliland, a regular on the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series. David Gilliland starts inside row five aboard that blue number 38 AES machine. To his outside, Ross Bales in the 75. Ross Bales, a great article in a recent edition of Late Model Illustrated from Ross Bales. Alex Chrome in the 27 AK machine will start sixth. And to his outside in that blue number 27 AES machine, from Gaffney, South Carolina, Rambo Franklin. Row 7, Ryan Atkins in the 9, and Adam Yarborough in the 57. Back in row 8, the 27H of Justin Hudspeth and the 16 of Ben Watkins. Corey Gordon from Charlotte, North Carolina, aboard that black number 23, starting inside row 9. To his outside is Jimmy Schultz of the 24. Danny Brewers in the blue 7 from Troutman, North Carolina. Jonathan Edwards in the 32. Jay Sessom in that white 00. Daniel Tucker in the 10G. Jeff Smith and Anthony Sanders start at the rear. We're underway. 30 laps of distance. Green flags in the air. And Matt Long wheeling and dealing alongside of Chris Ferguson. They're stuck together through 1 and 2. Now Fergie noses in front. Matt Long still rim riding up there looking for daylight. He'll fall in line, but here comes Brandon Overton down low. Overton in a battle with Long for second. Give it to Overton at the stripe. Down the back straightaway. Fergie into turn number three. Chris Ferguson's opened up a 10 car length advantage. Brandon Overton leads Matt Long from second to third. And Matt Long spins and crashes into the wall just short of the flag stand. Not sure what went wrong with Matt Long's car. He was battling for second with Brandon Overton. Overton was clear of him. Matt Long's car just immediately veered hard to the right and smacked the outside retaining wall. Safety crew members are on the scene. So Matt Long driving the Circle K Polar Pop number 25, and safety crew immediately putting the fire extinguishers on the car. So apparently it had flamed up, and Matt Long may have turned it hard right immediately. I'll have to wait and get another look at it. But everybody appears to be okay, out of harm's way. The onrush of traffic all got by Matt Long as he veered to the right immediately and right up against the wall. They have extinguished the flames, and Matt Long is moving around inside the cockpit of the Circle K Polar Pop number 25. Of the 24 drivers that started this event, 8 drivers stand the chance of picking up a $1,000 bonus, compliments of City Chevrolet. Thanks to Chris Blair and everyone at City Chevrolet for putting up that $1,000 bonus. The drivers eligible include Chris Ferguson, Timbo Mangum, Donnie Austin, Ross Bales, Rambo Franklin, Anthony Sanders, Jeff Smith, and unfortunately, the driver that just got out of the car. But the good news is Big Matt Long's A-OK. Give him a round of applause. Matt's had quite an impressive year on the track in that Circle K polar pop machine, but apparently tonight was not the night to be. So we've got two laps recorded as official with 28 remaining in this NDRA Great Lake Model feature, the closing main event for tonight's Circle K Outlaw Showdown. See if the field gets the one to go this time by Glenn Jarman high atop the flag stand at Charlotte Motor Speedway, and he motions for the Toyota Tundra Pace truck to clear the way. Back ready to go green. Fergie up front, Chris Ferguson. He's got Timbo Mangum and Brandon Overton directly behind him. There we go with two laps down, 28 remain. Pace truck into the infield. Ready to go green. Fergie's going to light the fuse out of turn four. They're in the gas, and we're underway. And a car will spin on the start at the back of the pack. Yellow back out immediately. Couple of cars involved. Adam Yarborough in the 57, the 24 machine of Jimmy Schultz also involved. So they've got the field restacked now. We'll see if we're able to go. Doesn't look like anybody's going to fall by the wayside by virtue of that little squirrel out situation in the back of the pack on the restart. Again, the we've just got two under our belts, and Ferguson leads them. Down out of turn four, they light the fuse. Green back in the air. Kimbo Mangum forces his way into second. Brandon Overton right there trying to shove him a little bit. Donnie Austin in the mix trying to battle from the fourth position. Oh, they're scattered three and four wide out of turn four. Mid-pack and back. One car off the pace right up against the wall. Ross Bales has stopped just short of the flag stand. So Ross Bales is number 75, stops short of the flag stand. The yellow comes out, and he has got some suspension damage in that right front corner of the car. So Bales is disabled here with three laps complete. Well, the officials continuing to work with the Ross Bales car on the front straightaway, hooking up to the Charlotte Motor Speedway wrecker. So apparently his evening done, as you see it right there on the jumbo screen. All right, they're about to get Ross Bales, his number 75, hooked up and ready to pull away as the rest of the field paces by in a single file formation. Field forms up now as scoring and timing for NDRA gets them lined back up. Nothing's changed up front. It's all about Fergie right now with three laps in. 22 car leads the way. one that goes to signal. A lot of takers for the chance of getting this trophy still yet on the racetrack. Chris Ferguson's going to try to hold off Kimbo Mangum and Brandon Overton. They are stacked up in that first double foul row. Greg Clark in the mix there, inside of row number two of double stack cars. Ready to go green. Ferguson will lead them back to the green flag. They're gassed up and on the move. Let's see what they do this time. Battles for second. Brandon Overton gets to the outside of Kimbo Mangum. Mangum's left to battle with Greg Clark for third. One car off the pace in turn number three, and he'll spin it. And now another car backwards. Ben Watkins took that 16 car into turn three. He slowed, and then he spun it around. He's pointed in the wrong direction. The 10 car with problems as well. That's Daniel Tucker in that 10G. But Ben Watkins with a problem in the 16. So we're under the yellow again. And Watkins out of his car surveying damage. So he's done. Caution lights out, and they'll go green again. Four laps complete into this scheduled for 30-lap feature. Chris Ferguson, Brandon Overton, and Kimbo Mangum, your top three. Well, we know Ferguson's from Mount Holly, North Carolina. Brandon Overton, I know, is from near Augusta, Georgia. Kimbo Mangum, He's from Lancaster, South Carolina. And now three more cars will spin. Actually, one sits remaining after Jimmy Schultz gets together with Atkins, and they run over each other in turn two. Now the Adam Yarborough car sitting across the racetrack in between turns one and two. A lot of damage on Danny Brewer's number seven car. The right front suspension destroyed on that machine as he turns it left into the infield. Ryan Atkins takes the nine car to the outside pit area. We'll try it again now with four laps complete. Let's see what Chris and the yellow flag comes back out. Chris Ferguson leads him down the back straightaway here as we go back green. And he'll have the field by about a half a straightaway. Now Brandon Overton begins to close in. Timbo Mangum running in third. Donnie Austin is your fourth place car, and he's trying to hold off the charge of Dennis Rambo Franklin. Franklin back in the fifth spot. David Gilliland, giddy up and galloping along. He's just gotten by Corey Gordon, and he'll close it on David Smith down in turn one. Caution out again as a 27H of Justin Hudspeth has spun exiting turn four. Jeff Smith takes it to the pits, pulls out of turn three, gets a look over. He started back in the 23rd position. Caution lights are off. Again, that was six laps complete. Single file restart. Chris Ferguson up front. Brandon Overton second. Then it's Timbo Mangum. Donnie Austin in the fourth spot. Dennis Rambo Franklin fifth. David Smith, David Gilliland, Corey Gordon, and the rest of the field. They go back green. Rambo on the move. He'll look to the inside and pick up a spot from Donnie Austin. David Gilliland working that high side of the racetrack. We'll see if he can make it work. He's right there behind David Smith. Close call for Daniel Tucker in the 10 car. Back at the back of the pack, but he kept it going in the right direction. Working on lap number 9. David Gilliland digging to the bottom of the racetrack as he tries to get underneath David Smith. Meanwhile, Rambo's on the move. Dennis Franklin's up to third. He got by Timbo Mangum and moved into that third spot. Brandon Overton trying to close on the leader. Down the back straightaway. Leaders out of turn 4. It's Chris Ferguson. Then Brandon Overton. Dennis Franklin runs third. Timbo Mangum fourth. David Smith fifth. That high wire act may have cost David Gilliland a shot at it. He actually switched and went to the bottom, and that allowed Donnie Austin and Corey Gordon to stay in front of him. Now Corey Gordon will pound Austin over in turn 3. Kind of shoved him right along, opened the door for David Gilliland to dig to the bottom. Race leader Chris Ferguson is in turn 3. Gilliland and Donnie Austin going at it for position. That's for the 6th spot. They're in turn 1. And David Gilliland will dig to the bottom and make the move pay off. All the while, Brandon Overton is cutting down the lead, one car slow in turn number 1. Looks like the double zero of Jay Sessom off the pace. So now with 13 laps complete, the yellow flies again. And that will allow Brandon Overton to close right back up to Chris Ferguson. And under that green flag run, Brandon Overton was cutting into that lead that Ferguson had. So Ferguson continues to lead. Brandon Overton in second. Dennis Franklin is up to third. Back in fourth, it's Timbo Mangum. In fifth, it's David Smith. And just outside the top 5, David Gilliland has worked his way up to the 6th spot. Yellow out as Ferguson, Overton, and Franklin, your front 3. One to go, the signal again with 13 laps complete of the scheduled 30. Going to go green. Ferguson, Overton, and Franklin. They like the candle out of turn four. Brandon Overton trying to make up some ground down the back straightaway. The Budweiser, number 76, trying to close it on Ferguson. Here comes Rambo. Wobbling and bobbling out of turn four. Rambo settles back down in line. Ferguson out of turn two. David Gilliland now battles his way up into the fifth spot as he wrestled past Timbo Mangum. So David Gilliland on the move. 16 laps complete. It's Ferguson, but closing now is Brandon Overton down in turns one and two. Overton married at the bottom of that racetrack. Cuts it down even more. Down the backstretch into turn three. The young Georgian, Brandon Overton, trying to chase down Chris Ferguson. Back in third, it's Rambo Franklin with David Smith in fourth. Battle for the lead down the backstretch into turn three. Here's Brandon Overton digging to the bottom of Ferguson. Overton will lead lap number 18. So the Budweiser 76 of Brandon Overton has taken the lead down the back straightaway. Brandon Overton trying to ring the bell tonight at Charlotte Motor Speedway. Ferguson bobbled again, and Dennis Franklin's up to second. Ferguson back to third. David Smith in fourth. David Gilliland in fifth. Overton out of turn four. He'll click off lap number 20. Can Dennis Franklin run him down? They're out of turn two. David Smith goes to the inside of Ferguson. That's the battle for third. They're side by side. Overton tries to pin his car to the bottom. Dennis Franklin's trying to track him down. David Gilliland on the move again. Laps are winding down now. Overton down the back chute. David Gilliland will muscle his way underneath Chris Ferguson. Move the Riverside, California driver Gilliland up to fourth. Overton across the stripe with eight to go. Rambo Franklin still runs in second. David Smith third. David Gilliland has tracked down David Smith in turn two. Ferguson has drifted back to fourth. Brandon Overton now trying to run a smart race to the end. 23 laps complete. Overton takes that Budweiser 76 out of turn two and down the back chute. No spot really in jeopardy right now here. There'll be six laps to go this time by for Brandon Overton. Dennis Franklin still holds a second spot. There's plenty of daylight between the leaders and the back markers. Leader into turn three as the first car at the back of the pack crosses a stripe. Five to go now, this time for Brandon Overton. Franklin in second, David Smith third, David Gilliland in fourth, and Chris Ferguson back to fifth. In sixth is Timbo Mangum. Seventh goes to Donnie Austin, Corey Gordon in eighth. Coming down to this, can Rambo track down Overton? Across the stripe they go. Down the back straightaway. Time is running out. Dennis Franklin trying to close up on Brandon Overton. Across the stripe with three to go. Overton again down into turns one and two, and Franklin's there. Rambo starting to put some pressure on him now. The 27 of Franklin drifts up the banking. He'll dive down to the bottom in turn three. Out of turn four, Overton and Franklin flash across the stripe. Two to go. Now they're closing in on traffic. Overton with a smooth exit out of turn number two. Down the back chute, he'll rumble. Into turn three. He's got a little advantage over Rambo Franklin. They come to the stripe. who rockets his way to victory here tonight at Charlotte Motor Speedway. Rambo Franklin unable to run him down. Brandon Overton has pulled off a huge win tonight in the NDRA Great Lake Models. The Budweiser number 76, the kid out of Augusta, Georgia, has taken his Wolfpack racing machine to victory lane here tonight. We'll have our winners in victory lane momentarily, including our feature winner for the World of Outlaws feature, and our newest winner here tonight in the NDRA Crate Late Model Division, young Brandon Overton. What a story that kid is. Rick Eckert's out of the car, and the champion driver from York, Pennsylvania, has done something that he's never done before. Of course, last year, Rick Eckert captured the World of Outlaw Late Model Championship right here at Charlotte Motor Speedway. Hey, it's your first feature win here, bud. Congratulations.
Yeah, it's turning to be one of my favorite places.
You always have some happy moments here. What about it? That race out there was just, it was all up for grabs tonight.
Yeah, you had to have your elbows up, and then you had to take care of your tires, too. Racetrack, it was a little bit narrow. They did a great job it said it rained here for a week and a half. They did a great job just getting it in, you know. So it was struggled a little bit there early, and then they got her run in, and then it widened out a little bit. And it was plenty of lanes to race out there in the race. It was actually a really good race.
You're on a pretty good streak right now. Of course, you had a couple of wins this past weekend. That means a lot to your racing program, Rick.
Sure does, and the season's going to end.
Congratulations, Knight. What about a lot of people that are behind you? I mean, you got a lot of people to make it happen for you to get in these victory lanes.
Yeah, I got to thank All-Star Performance, J&K Salvi, Jecker Trucking, Jay Dickens Race Engine. That thing runs well. Richie Sandblasting, All About Wraps, Hoosier Tire, Heinz Performance. Steve Heinz, I had his shirt on all day. I think it brought me good luck. So, you know, it's always fun to come down here and race. He has a suite up there. I never get to go to it. Fortunately, I don't want to go up there. But I'd sooner be out there racing. Maybe one day I will.
I'll guarantee you one thing. They were jumping and hopping up there tonight here when you won that feature event. Your winner of the World of Outlaws Circle K Late Model Challenge, the Outlaw Challenge, York, Pennsylvania's Rick Eckert. And to the victor goes the spoils, the championship trophy, so Rick can strike the pose here tonight. Rick Eckert, the 2011 champion of the World of Outlaw Late Models, returns to Charlotte, where he claims another feature win, and the team will join him up on the stage now.